All right. LDBC, this is your boy, Coach Sheldon Harrison. You're live on the Coach Sheldon Harrison Combat Sports Show Live. Okay, folks, you know, this fight, it was definitely a barometer for Kell Brook to see, you know, how was the eye going to hold up. You know, I mean, was he going to be confident? Was he going to do the things that he was supposed to do in this fight? I'll say two of the three things that I mentioned were answered. The eye, he didn't really get hit in his eye. He barely got touched in this fight at all, so we won't know exactly how the eye is going to hold up, maybe in his next fight. But he went in here and he dictated the pace of this fight. In round one, he set traps for Rabchenko. And Rabchenko walking in the uppercuts, walking in the straight right hands. And that straight right hand of Kell Brook is one of his major weapons. That's a good weapon for Kell Brook. And he just had Rabchenko pretty much walking into him, you know. That's just how it is. Rabchenko, I don't know, man, he got gunshot. When he felt the power of Kell Brook, he just didn't want to throw any more punches, man. He was done. I mean, he was literally done. After he took an uppercut in the first round, after the round was about to be over, he was done. And I kind of knew it because when he went back to his corner, man, you know, he had that look in his eyes, man, like, nah, man, this dude on a whole nother level. I don't think I can beat him. He had that I don't think I can beat him look, which I was like, man, okay. So, you know, Rabchenko finna go out like that. Okay, he finna go out like that. But, you know, Rabchenko, he came in round two. He started trying to put pressure on Kell Brook. And then Kell Brook just started two-piecing his ass to death, man, just hitting him 1-2. That 1-2. You know how Kell Brook do that 1-2. But it started off with a good combination. He caught Rabchenko with an uppercut that staggered him. And then he hit Rabchenko with a 1-2, and then he dropped him, man. And I thought Rabchenko could have got up, man. But, you know, Rabchenko kind of, you know, he kind of looked up, man. And I knew this guy didn't want to fight no more, man. As soon as he hit the canvas, he started looking around, and then he looked at the ref. You know, then he got up at the last minute. He got up at the last minute. I'm like, nah, this guy don't want to fight. This guy don't want to fight. He was waiting on a referee to wave it off, and hey, the ref stopped the fight, man. It went, and you know, when the fight was over, you know, Rabchenko wasn't like, hey, man, you stopped the fight, sure. Nah, Rabchenko wasn't trying. Nah, he was like, hey, man, I got out this alive. But, you know, it was a good win for Kell Brook, man. I'm glad that Kell Brook got this win because, man, that last knockout loss to Errol Spence Jr., now this guy done fought two dogs, man, and, you know, it's okay to fight a puppy, man, you know. But I wonder, where does he go from here? He's at 154, man. You got a lot of killers at 154. A lot of killers at 154. And one of those killers at 154, I guarantee you, he is going to call out Kell Brook. I promise you. Jermell Charlo is going to call out Kell Brook. And that's just how it is. That's how it is. But, you know, I don't think it's time to jump to a conclusion yet. I don't even know if the fight would ever happen, man. It'd have to be up to Eddie Hearn. And we know how Eddie Hearn is. But you guys tell me what you think about this fight. This is your boy, Coach Sheldon Harrison. I'm done. What are you waiting on? Subscribe.